Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. For today's video, I want to share some of my personal favorite quarantine recommendations to you guys. So I know that all of us, or most of us, are still stuck in quarantine and we're just finding for new ways to distract ourselves, picking up on new hobbies or learning new things. So I've divided this video into five different parts, which is my favorite books, movies, podcast, TV shows, anything written in my notebook. So if I look down a little, don't mind. So let's start with the first segment, which is books. So starting with the first recommendation, it's a book called Maybe You Should Talk to Someone by Laurie Gottlieb. I hope I'm saying that right. But if you follow me on Instagram, you probably know that I started reading this book almost a week ago and I just finished it yesterday. It is absolutely beautiful. So it's so much insight about life. It's sort of a book about Laurie being a therapist and how she goes to a therapist herself, which is just a beautiful story. It's funny, it has some beautiful advice within the book, and you definitely do feel a whole lot more wiser, I would say, after reading it, because it talks about the power of being able to transform yourself and how it's never too late to sort of bring in changes. I don't want to say too much because I would recommend you should read this. So moving on to my second book recommendation, we have a book that's called Everything I Know About Love by Dolly Adelton. Just a couple of pages into the book and I already know that this is something that I relate to and I can totally, I don't know, resonate with, I feel. The general summary of the book is that it talks about the life of a lady all the way from her young school childhood days all the way to a fully grown adult. So it takes you through things such as school or like getting drunk for the first time or the idea of sort of fitting in, finding a job, finding someone to settle down with, and just, I feel like it's a book that's gonna make me feel nostalgic in some ways, because obviously who I was when I was 16 and who I am today when I'm 21 are completely different people. So I do feel like this book is gonna bring out so many emotions in me, and I've also heard that it's received a lot of awards. So I'm very excited to complete reading this book, but I did want to mention this within the recommendations because I know that this is a book you guys are gonna love as well. So yeah. So moving on to TV shows, one of my absolute favorites is Crash Landing on You. I've spoken about this on my Instagram. I absolutely love that show. So I've recently started watching K-drama because of my sister. So this is one of those shows that I feel like I could watch again and again. Basic summary of the show, it's about a South Korean lady who goes parasailing and gets stuck in North Korea, and it's about how she falls in love with like a North Korean soldier and how she is hiding in their country and basically finding ways to leave. And it just talks about the journey of friendship, and also if you're interested in the life of North Korea in some ways, it did intrigue me. I was very interested to see how the show would sort of evolve. So I feel like if you're someone who's interested in a story that's quite different, I would say watch Crash Landing on You and send me a message on Instagram or comment here once you're done and tell me what you think of it. My second TV show recommendation, I watched the season 2 of FOMO Shorts and I really loved it. It was just so much emotions and drama. Also, if you don't know what that is, it's a show on Amazon Prime. It's a story about four friends, their lives and their friendship and how they sort of stand together irrespective of what happens and all the fights that happen between them. So it is something that you can watch if you're just, if you just want to watch something full of drama, and it's quite intense, I would say. It talks about breaking stereotypes, and yeah, watch the show, I'm sure you like it. So the third show recommendation is Dynasty. I have been watching the show for quite a while now, and their recent season I think came out a couple of weeks or months ago, and I am so hooked. It's a story about a very, very rich family and just sort of the drama that happens in their house, and it's, I don't really know how to describe Dynasty, but it's just really crazy. It's about money and power, and it just has a lot going on. Also, there's a bit of love and like family related stuff, but it's just like crazy in that house. Moving on to the last TV show recommendation, I watched a show called Schitt's Creek and I loved it. I do know there's not a lot of people who liked it. Like, I asked my dad to see it and he didn't really like it, but my mom and me enjoyed it. So it's about a rich family who basically loses all their fortune overnight, and then they move into this really, really small remote town and live in like a rundown motel. So it just talks about how they sort of grow as people, how they grow as a family, and it's quite funny just to see how like someone so crazily rich sees like the basic things in life. Something that you can watch that is just very lighthearted, and also by the end of it you're just gonna feel, it's a feel-good show, I would say. It is a feel-good show and I really enjoyed watching it. So moving on to the next segment, which are movies. Honestly, I don't really have a lot of recommendations within this because I really haven't watched a lot of movies or TV shows. I've just avoided binge watching because I feel like it really affects my eyes. So yeah, I just rewatched some old stuff. So starting with the first recommendation is a movie called The Wrong Missy. It is so extremely funny. It's just about this guy and a girl who sort of meet on their first date and he finds her so extremely weird. How their relationship develops and how coincidentally she keeps coming back into his life, and she's just really, really out of her mind crazy. So I would say watch that movie. I think it's on Netflix. It is extremely lighthearted, a good like comedy sort of movie, and yeah, it's just a nice watch, I would say. Moving on to the fourth segment, which is a podcast. So I discovered podcasts, I would say, a good 4 months ago, and I have been enjoying it. So one of my first recommendations is called The One with the Friends. And yes, it is based on the TV show. So the podcast is by two friends, and they break down every single episode, talk about why certain things played out the way that it did, or what was sort of the meaning behind certain things that happened in the show and how it is relatable even today to certain life situations. So if you're a Friends fan, I would say go watch it. You're really gonna love it. So the next recommendation is What's Next by Michelle Reed. So this is also a show that talks about navigating your life in your 20s, and also about the fact that we're so used to listening to the same thing again. You finish school, you go to college, then you find a job, and like life is supposed to be a certain way. So she talks about how you're expected to sort of figure your life out and the pressures you often feel when you're surrounded or you've finished a certain level of an accomplishment, what the society would call it, how you shouldn't really be bothered by what the society has to say, and how you need to feel a little less pressurized by the outside world and feel a little more inspired by you. And the last podcast recommendation is called Happiness Spells. It talks about how to appreciate and feel gratitude in understanding what the right thing would be to do in certain situations and how it is important to have strong morals. So it's definitely very eye-opening. You learn so much. There is just so much you get to experience while listening to what other people have gone through. That's it for today's video. I'm really hoping you guys have taken something back and now have some new TV shows or books or podcasts to listen to. Also, don't forget to let me know what your recommendations are, because I'd love to learn from you guys and we can sort of exchange what's good. Just kidding. But yeah, thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below, and all those other things. See you guys next time. Bye.